The chairman for your kind introduction. Good morning, everyone. My name is Hsieh-Shen Hsieh. Today, my presentation is measure for performance improve and the size shrinkage of a 3-axis piezoresistive accelerometer with guiding structure. The outline shows 5 parts of this presentation. Firstly, I will briefly give some introduction and then go to the motivation and introduce the approach of this study. Next, I'm going to give the 5-element model verification result. After that, the following optimum design and its result will be given. Finally, conclusion will be given. Now, let's take a look in the first part. MEMS accelerometers are widely applied in consumer electronics or automobile. MEMS accelerometer can detect MEMS accelerometer provide motion sensing to detect the human or machine movement. However, in fact, MEMS accelerometer is a force sensor intrinsically. Therefore, how to avoid the unwanted force disturbance is a tough issue to improve the accuracy of the accelerometer. For the existing accelerometer, the spring is direct anchored to the substrate. Any distance change between these two anchors will lead to the spring deformation and interfere the sensor output. For the accelerometer with guiding structure, the spring is fixed to the surrounding guiding, and the guiding only anchor to the substrate at one end. That's the structural deformation due to the temperature variation or substrate loading can be released from this free end. The top figure show the design of the accelerometer with guiding structure and its verification result. Now let's move on to the second part, motivation and the approach approach overview. Although the accelerometer with guiding structure significantly suppress the unwanted disturbance. However, the die size as well as cost is also increased due to the existing of stress isolation structure. Therefore, it's important to consider the size of the stress isolation structure to be a design factor. In this study, we propose an optimal design to shrinkage the size of stress isolation structure and maintain the performance of the sensor. This slide illustrates our main approach to optimal design. The commercial 5-element software Coventor is being employed to evaluate the candidate design. The orthogonal array and the SN ratio in Taguchi method is being used in this study. The orthogonal array will offer the prediction capability of candidate design. The SN ratio is index to show the sensor performance over the environment disturbance and will help in data analysis. Moreover, unlike traditional Taguchi method, we using five element result instead of really experimentation. Under the assistance of 5-element and the Taguchi method, we could get the optimal design. Before we using the 5-element to evaluate our candidate design, we shall verify our 5-element model. This slide shows the sensitivity comparison between the experimental result and the simulated result. It could be observed the simulated result agree well with the experimental result. This slide shows the comparison of the type 3 resonant frequency between the experimental result and the fine element result of the original design. And the result predicted by fine element agree well with loss from the experiment. Based on the above analysis, the simulation is considered reliable. Therefore, we could use the fine element model to evaluate our candidate design. Now let's go to the optimum design and its result. This slide show the system overview of Piezoresistive Accelerometer under the frame deformation inference. The design parameters such as the connection bridge, the location of the connection bridge, the dimension of guardrail, the size of connection bridge is be considered as the control factor. The frame deformation due to the packaging or environmental disturbance is be considered as noise factor. Its effect on sensors performance shifter is be considered as quality characteristic. The size of the stress isolation structure is another key index to consider the optimum design. The optimum design is be expected to maintain the quality characteristic under the frame deformation inference. This slide show the design parameter of in this study. The first factor is the location of connection bridge. The second factor is the length of guardrail. The third factor is the width of guardrail. The fourth factor is the guardrail thickness. The fifth factor is the guardrail length. And the last factor is the connection bridge. And they all list in this table. We arrange our design parameter combination according to the orthogonal array and get the fine element simulation result of those candidate design under the frame deformation inference. This slide shows the factor effect Hsieh-Shen ratio diagram after data analysis. As shown in the figure, the largest Hsieh-Shen ratio difference is between the two levels of factor A. Therefore, the main inference factor is the location of the connection bridge. The ranking of top three powerful factor is ACE. Those factors have the relative large influence on sensors output. This table lists three characteristics of this study. We are going to implement a comprehensive evaluation to determine the optimum parameter. For the factor A mainly influences the sensor's output on zero G offset shifter or sensitivity shifter, and is not affecting the size of stress isolation structure. Therefore, we should choose the parameter with larger Hsieh-Shen ratio. Therefore, the optima parameter is A1 in here. A1 has the diagonal connection bridge. For the factor B affecting the size of the stress isolation structure and has less contribution on the sensor's performance. Therefore, we should choose the parameter with smaller stress isolation structure. Therefore, the optima parameter is B1. The following according to the similar criterion, the optima parameter of the following factor can be determined in here. Based on above systematic analysis, the conclusion is the performance of the accelerometer is being improved both in little g of phase shift and the sensitivity shift for one order of magnitude. And the size of stress isolation structure has been shrunk from 29%. The unwanted higher vibration mode are far away from the first mode. Therefore, the proposed accelerometer design keep the advantage of the original three-axis accelerometer. In this study, we propose a systematic measure to performance improve and the size shrinkage of a accelerometer. In the future, we will implement and characterize three-axis accelerometer with stress isolation guiding and the diagonal connection bridge in practical package. We would like to thank those organizations for supporting relative manufacturing and the testing facility. Thank you for your attention.
Yes.
The higher mode is the relative to the connection bridge, the guiding structure. You could see in here. Actually, the higher mode is 17 kHz. Original design is 17 kHz and the optimum design is 16 kHz. It doesn't imprint vibration.
So your sensor happened because you developed it as well.
Yes. We discussed in the first question, and it's a three-axis accelerometer. This is the first three resonant frequency for three-axis sensing, and this is for the this is unwanted vibration mode. It's far away from the sensing mode. And this accelerometer is mainly for the consumer electronics. Therefore, I think the bandwidth is enough. In this study, we just the result get from the induced temperature. We did not do any thermal characteristic of this sensor. Not yet.